Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. And what we got on the test bench today is the Cat Tail from the good people at Fuzzrocious. Now, Fuzzrocious are literally a husband and wife duo in New Jersey who make these amazing hand-built and hand-painted pedals. And the Cat Tail represents an evolution of their Rat Tail distortion pedal, which they describe as a low to high gain pedal that sounds fuzzy at higher volumes, or rather higher distortion settings. Works equally well into a distorted or a clean amp. You heard us playing through a distorted Orange TH30 in the intro jam. We'll explore that more in a moment, and we're also going to run into the clean channel. But first of all, let's talk about some spec, specifically this little switch down here. Now, because these pedals are all made to order, you can order them with all sorts of cool modifications to them. And this is a momentary feedback switch. You can also order it with a latching feedback switch, or you can order it with a second distortion switch, or all sorts of other things. Kill switches are available. You can get them without a switch as well if you want. And this bright red control over here, this is our feedback control. Allow me to demonstrate. So I'm not going to play anything on the guitar just yet. I'm literally just going to hold this down. Which sounds like your guitar is being invaded by an army of angry aliens of varying sizes and the occasional kettle. I think it's fantastic, and because it's on a momentary switch, you can just drop this in kind of mid-playing. So for argument's sake, if I was going to play something a bit like this, I could literally just throw in that momentary feedback pedal a bit like this. Now, of course, it's a little hard to operate if you're doing the pedal with your hands. It really is designed for foot operation, but it's a lot of fun, and I'm sure you can already imagine a bunch of creative possibilities for that one. Let's not fixate on the gimmick side of it, though, because this is a great sounding pedal with a load of interesting features. Let's talk about the controls and the specs and what they all do. First of all, the three white controls are probably the most familiar to pedal users out there. We have a volume, self-explanatory, a filter control, which you may think of as a tone control, rolls off a load of high end. So as you start to turn it this way, it rolls off high end like this. So it works contrary to the way you'd expect a standard tone control and a distortion pedal to work. Think of it more as kind of a high cut filter, if you want to call it that. And of course, the obligatory distortion control, there is quite a lot of gain on tap. If we turn it to, let's say about 9 o'clock, let's explore how it sounds. And as we turn things up a little bit further, 12 o'clock, we get this. If that's a little too lairy for you, we can turn the filter control up to match, which gives us this sort of noise. Which has already rolled off a bunch of that kind of scratchy high end. That may be a little too rolled off for you. It really depends upon your amp and your guitar setup and how much distortion you've got dialed in. I'm going to dial that back a little bit, and we'll turn the distortion all the way and see what it does. In addition to this, there are two clipping controls which control the first and second clipping diodes, and there is also a little toggle switch on the top which selects either silicon, which we have right now, or LED clipping. Now the silicon clipping is a little bit mushier and a bit kind of less defined on the low end and a bit fuzzier perhaps, whereas the LED is a bit harder around the edges and behaves a little more like a distortion pedal, I suppose you may think about it. So let's start by playing with these clipping settings. We're going to start with everything up at 12 o'clock, and I'm going to switch between silicon and the LED clipping. You'll hear how it sounds. Now let's roll those two clipping diodes down a little bit and we'll see how they behave once again, switching between silicon and LED. And just for giggles, we're going to turn them both all the way up and see what happens. And there's a lot of fun to be had by mismatching these two. So if we start by turning clipping diode 1 all the way back, and then we keep clipping diode 2 up, it's going to give us this sort of effect. And again, switching from silicon to LED. And then if we mismatch them in the opposite direction, we turn clipping diode up, and then we turn, clipping diode 1 up and clipping diode 2 back. Let's try that one more time. Again, we'll switch the LED and silicon switch on the top as we go. Loads of fun to be had. So one more time, what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch back to our clean channel. Again, this is the Orange TH30. All the examples barring the intro jam you've heard so far have been on the clean channel. Clean sound sounds a little bit like this, just for reference. And engaging the pedal, we're going to get this wonderful wall of filth that sounds a little bit like this. And now we switched across to the dirty channel on our TH30. Sounds a little bit like this. It's not hugely distorted, but enough to make the pedal behave differently. Let's engage it and see how that sounds. Loads of fun. So there's all sorts of interesting sonic mayhem to be had out of the Cat Tail. Of course, with all these options, we're really only scratching the surface with this little review, but I'm a huge fan of this. Of course, as you know, I do like myself a little bit of fuzz. And while this is ostensibly not a fuzz pedal, it's a distortion pedal that can sound a little fuzzy, I think it does the job of that fuzz, thick wall of kind of filth and awesomeness just beautifully. Anyway, my name is Nick Jennison with Guitar Interactive Magazine. This is the Fuzzrocious Cat Tail, and I will see you next time.